You know, I was just thinking the same thing about Meghan's extraordinary. You know, you only hear a tenth of it of what she does in her own personal life with that. You know, when you have a great event and there's music and movement and dancing and the like, chances are you might hear a song like this one. Oh my gosh, I love the Go-Go's, and an original member of Vital Part, musician, songwriter, author, part of the Go-Go's, Kathy Valentine, joins us via Skype from her native Texas. Kathy, good morning to you. Really good to have you here.
Thank you. Hello, Los Angeles, my other home, home away from home.
I see the guitars in the background there. You're such a talented, talented guitarist. The title of the book, All I Ever Wanted, as the Go-Go's found this extraordinary sort of first ever success, was it in fact all you ever wanted?
It really was. Finding the Go-Go's, the minute I picked up a guitar in Austin, Texas, I was kind of driven to find like-minded gals like myself that wanted to be, you know, be in a band. And I found them in LA. I found an amazing band that really fulfilled and kind of manifested my biggest dreams and hopes.
All right, and then comes the good news and maybe the not so good news. You guys have a huge hit and then a hit album and then to the road. And was all of that as heady and wonderful? You know, gosh, everybody in the world wants a hit record, but there's a lot more to it than that, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot more work, but we managed to make so much of it fun. We got very adept at entertaining ourselves, relieving boredom, and we're the only people going through that experience. So there was a really special bond that has maintained over decades now.
In some of the blurbs about the book, there's some pretty good name drops. The Police, Rod Stewart, Rob Lowe. Want to pick up one of those names and tell me a story?
Well, I love the fact that when we opened for the Police, who were the biggest band in the entire world at the time, and it really played a big part and our success journey because we were exposed to their massive audiences. But there's a really funny story in the book where they invited us to fly on their private plane somewhere, and I didn't go because I was scared. The next night, I got another chance, did it again, and the plane caught on fire. So I'm like going, oh my God, my intuition and my premonition were off by 24 hours. And there's loads of stories. I was really blessed to have the opportunity to meet some of my favorite people.
There have been reunions and tours involving the band in subsequent years. How are you with the other three ladies now? Is everybody friendly, or are there fissures in that? Tell me.
No, there's actually five of us, so okay. It's another four, other four. And we have a documentary coming out on Showtime this summer, and it premiered in January, and we had a tour scheduled for this summer, and we are really in a great, great place. And yeah, there's been lots of ups and downs, and like a family, really, like a family where you might like skip a Thanksgiving here and there. But we're in a great place. It actually feels more now like it felt in the beginning.
Here's the thing, and maybe this is a cliche phrase. I don't know if the word timeless is the right word, but these hits sound completely current to me. They don't sound old to me. Why do you think that is?
I think because it's a good song is a good song. And we were very fortunate that our songs weren't recorded with any trappings or gimmicks that were central to a certain era. So we're really grateful to, you know, the way they were done. But I agree, we have been going out for decades now and not a lot of fanfare. You know, concerts these days can be a big spectacle. And we're just five women playing our songs up on stage. And it is connecting with a new audience every time. And it really is the power of a good song.
I tell you what, there's no question about the power of a good book. You can check out a conversation with Kathy Valentine, the virtual book tour. That will be streamed live tomorrow at 6 p.m. More information, Book Soup, the bookstore, of course, on Sunset, has all the details at booksoup.com. All I Ever Wanted from Kathy Valentine. Frank and Jessica, I love hearing those songs. I really, really do. Couldn't get enough of it.
I know. They're great. Thank you, Sam.